Hi, this is Carrie, aka Knit Pearl Girl, and I'm just going to show you how to get started knitting. You just need a ball of yarn and a pair of knitting needles. That's all you need to get started. You can use straight knitting needles or circular needles. It doesn't really matter. For the purposes of my demonstration, I'm going to use circular needles, but like I said, it does not matter. You take the end of the yarn and give yourself a good 5 to 6 inches. Take the part that's going toward the ball and you're going to loop it over like that. Okay, and then you'll hold this in your hand. Maybe you can see it. It's looped over. You're going to take this part of the yarn and you're going to go underneath like this and pull it up. And see how it creates a loop? That's called a slip knot. And that is the basis for starting any knitting project. So you're going to take your needle, put it in this loop, and you can pull the tail end or the end toward the working yarn, doesn't matter. You can pull either snug. Now you don't want it so snug that it doesn't move. It has to be able to move on your needle. So here we have the tail end over here and the end that's going toward the ball of your yarn, which is called the working yarn. So what we're going to do is we're going to learn a simple cast on, which is called single cast on or thumb cast on. So you take this needle into your right hand and you're going to set this tail end aside. Okay, you can take the working end, which is again, oops, I took that off there, the yarn that's coming off the ball. Okay, and a good thing is if you are moving it around, you'll notice that your stitch will slide. Just put your finger on it so it doesn't come off. Now take this yarn, the working end, and put it in your hand like this. Hold on to that. Take your thumb, go over the yarn like this. Now take your needle and pick that loop up and let it go onto your yarn. That is a cast on. You've cast on one stitch. We're going to do that again. The yarn is in your hand. You're going to take your thumb, put this finger on these stitches here so that they don't slide off. Put your thumb over and bring it up and take your needle, go underneath and bring it like this. Let's do it again. Hold on to these stitches on your right hand needle with your index finger. Take your thumb, go over, take your right hand needle, go under and let the loop come up. And do it again. Now, the way you count the stitches is this. However many loops are on your needle are how many stitches you have cast on. That includes the initial slip knot that you had on your needle. So we now have 5 stitches on our needle. So when a pattern says to cast on 5 stitches, you will count how many loops are on the needle, and if there are 5, you have cast on the correct amount. Once you're done with casting on, the needle with the stitches on it will then become your left hand needle. It will move over to your left hand. The needle with no stitches on it will become your right hand needle. And this will become the needle in which you work the stitches off your left hand. In the next video, I'll show you how to do the knit stitch so that you can start working these cast on stitches.